Like Wolf was made in 1992 by TXC for the Micro Genius series of Nintendo Family Computer clones. It is one of the very few NES games which measure the Y screen position with the zapper. Another game which does this is Lethal Weapon, which I reviewed in episode 18. I have heard Strike Wolf was sold together with the Micro Genius TLG 405 Uzi-like looking light gun. In the game's story, the player is held prison by a group of terrorists. As someone approaches the player to apply a threatening looking syringe, the player manages to slip the handcuffs and fight the way out. The player then goes on to stop the terrorists. The player uses a semi-automatic gun with infinite capacity but limited stock of ammunition. Special controller inputs allow the player throwing grenades or firing shots at the last hit position. For this purpose, light guns with additional buttons, such as the Bandai Hypershot and the Micro Genius TLG 405, are supposed to be used. If the player chooses to utilize a zapper type light gun instead, the zapper has to be inserted to port 2, while a gamepad is connected in port 1. The A button will then shoot normal bullets at the last hit position, and the B button fires grenades. The game consists of 6 levels, which are all concluded in a boss fight. The first level is an arsenal. The second level is a desert. The next level is located in an ammunition depot. The fourth level takes the player to an airport. Level 5 is an airfield. The last level takes place at a harbor. Some enemies fire toxic black clouds towards the player. Once hit, the health bar will steadily decrease until the player is dead or manage to pick up an antidote. The player may pick up gas masks, which protect against these clouds. Besides health, ammunition and grenade pickups, there is an item which grants unlimited ammunition during a short time. Unlimited continues allow the player to retry every level from the beginning with restocked ammunition and grenades. The bosses must be shot at weak spots and are invulnerable otherwise. There is quite a variety of bosses ranging from humans over small vehicles to huge machines. As told in the beginning of this video, the hit detection is very special in this game. Upon shooting, the screen turns white for 2 frames. The gun then detects the Y position of the screen. The game then sends a white ball to this position, which traverses frame by frame X sections of the screen. If the gun detects the white ball, the ball stops moving and the hit is detected in this field. This method effectively divides the screen into hitbox sections. A better known light gun game which divides the screen into tiles more noticeably is Snatcher, made by Konami. Personally, I really like the game. The music and the graphics are very good. To me, the way the game handles its hit detection is nothing short of amazing. Compared to Lethal Weapon, the difficulty is less balanced in my opinion though, and therefore I like it less. I would say the game is a notch too hard. The label looks outstanding and is artfully drawn. My acknowledgement goes to Javier Goy for allowing me to show this cartridge from his outstanding collection. A link to his YouTube channel can be found in the video description. The cartridge I played for this review was custom made for me by the Modern Retro Gaming Alliance, short MRGA. I deal with custom gaming hardware from all around the world on a regular basis for several years now. In my personal opinion, the MRGA is the number one competence in retro gaming. I contacted them via the Facebook page and I recommend everybody with complex custom needs to do so too. This is the end of the review. My name is Ben. I thank you for viewing.